right, they're here.
What's here?
I'll show you. My x-ray glasses. Ooh, Persis, I can see right through you.
No, you can't.
How would you know?
Because those cheap glasses aren't going to give you x-ray vision. That's impossible.
Okay, whatever you say. Well, you know, brings up an interesting question. Most of us have had an x-ray picture taken of some part of our body. Have you ever wondered why x-rays can see through us? Well, I hate to burst your bubble, but the truth is x-rays don't really see through you. What they really do is the same thing this light is doing to my hand. They produce a shadow. Of course, this shadow doesn't look very much like an x-ray. It looks more like a bird. Or a deer. Sorry. You see, the problem with the shadow cast by a light is you can't see any detail. But x-rays are a little different. X-rays belong to the same radiation spectrum as radio waves, microwaves, and visible light. The big difference is that x-rays have a lot more energy, which means they can pass through objects that the other wavelengths can't. It also means that x-rays can pass right through your body. But if they all passed right through, you wouldn't get much of a shadow. Well, fortunately, not all of them do get through. And the reason is that old property called density. Everything around us is made up of atoms, but the spaces between those atoms can vary between objects. And the closer the atoms, the denser the material. It's like comparing a styrofoam ball with a billiard ball. The atoms in the billiard ball are packed much closer together, so it has a greater density. Now, fortunately, our bodies also contain materials of different densities. More specifically, our bones have a greater density than our skin or our muscles. And that fact is what makes medical x-rays possible. To take an x-ray picture, you need three things. A machine that can generate x-rays, a body part to shoot the x-rays at, and finally, you need some way to record what happens. Now, luckily, x-rays have the same effect on photographic film as light. They expose it. So underneath the body part, we slip a large plate of unexposed film. But where does that shadow thing fit into all this? Remember I said that your bones are more dense than the rest of your body? Well, when you take an x-ray, here's what happens. The atoms in your skin and muscle are far enough apart that most of the x-rays can easily pass through to the film underneath. But the atoms in your bones are much closer together, so only a small percentage of the x-rays actually make it through. The result is that the section of film that lies underneath your bones is exposed to far fewer x-rays than the rest of the film. So your bones are essentially casting their shadow onto the film. But if shadows are dark, then why do your bones look white in an x-ray picture? Well, when we take a regular photograph, we expose the film inside the camera to light. And when the film is developed, we end up with a negative. Okay, everyone, smile! We call it a negative because the areas that were bright in the original picture now look dark, and the areas that were dark now look white. And that's what an x-ray is. It's a photographic negative where dense objects like bones that block the x-ray beam show up white. But breaks in the bone show up as dark lines because the beam is able to pass right through and expose the film underneath. And because metal has a greater density than bone, in an x-ray it shows up even brighter than bone. Now, with regular photographs, we eventually make a print from the negative and turn it into a positive image. Well, at airports, we do a similar thing with x-rays. The security scanner that checks your luggage uses an X-ray beam to see inside. Except in this case, dense objects now appear dark instead of white. Now, while X-rays are great for examining bones or luggage, they do have some limitations. They're not very good at diagnosing injuries to soft tissues that have similar densities, like muscles or nerves. For those injuries, we have to use different imaging technologies that rely on other properties besides density. We also can't use X-rays to look at babies in the womb. Instead, we use an ultrasound machine. It's not that X-rays couldn't do the job. The problem is they could seriously damage the baby. That's the one drawback of X-rays. Because they contain so much energy, they can literally rip through your body like tiny bullets. And in fact, each time you have an X-ray taken, you do sustain a small amount of damage. But it's so minimal that unless you have a lot of X-rays taken over a very short period of time, it's not harmful. However, what you do want to avoid is passing X-rays through cells that are rapidly dividing, like in a growing baby. The problem is, the X-rays can break apart the strands of DNA that provide the genetic code for your body. And in rapidly dividing cells, damage to the DNA can lead to birth defects. That's why before you have an X-ray taken, they often place one of these dense lead aprons over your private areas. You see, the purpose is to protect the DNA in your cells down there so you don't have any reproductive problems down the road.
And just hold your breath. So when are you going to take those stupid glasses off?
I take it you're referring to my stupid X-ray glasses that don't work?
Yeah, those.
Yeah, I guess you're right. They don't work. Oh, by the way, nice polka dot underwear you got on today.
Give me those!